In this lesson, we will try to analyze time complexity of recursive implementation of Fibonacci sequence. In an earlier lesson, we had shown how and why recursive implementation of Fibonacci sequence, a simple recursive implementation of Fibonacci sequence, is lot costlier than iterative implementation where we simply write a loop. Let's try to deduce it mathematically. As we know, Fibonacci sequence is a sequence in which the first two elements are 0 and 1 and all other elements are sum of previous two elements. And a recursive program to find an element in the above sequence goes something like this. If n is less than or equal to 1, which accounts for the first two elements in the sequence, we simply return n. Else we make two recursive calls to calculate fib of n minus 1 and fib of n minus 2, sum them up and return the value. Let's say time taken to calculate fib of n is tn. Now, when we try to analyze time complexity of programs, we make an assumption that each simple operation takes 1 unit of time. So if we call this method fib of n for n greater than 1, then first we perform a comparison here with 1, which is 1 unit of cost. Let's say 1 unit of cost is there for comparison, and because n is greater than 1, so it goes to the else condition, the control of the program. And here we make two recursive calls where we pass arguments as n minus 1 and n minus 2. So we make two subtractions. So there is 1 unit of cost for this subtraction and 1 unit of cost for this subtraction, and then 1 unit of cost for this addition. So for n greater than 1, there are 4 simple operations, 2 subtractions, 1 addition and 1 comparison. Now time taken to calculate fib of n can be written as time taken to calculate fib of n minus 1, which is tn minus 1, plus time taken to calculate fib of n minus 2, which is tn minus 2, plus 4 units of time for these simple operations. If n is less than or equal to 1, which is the case for t0 and t1, we only have one simple operation, which is comparison. So here the time taken is 1 unit. Now let us try to reduce tn in terms of these known values, which are t0 and t1. But before I do that, I will try an approximation and I will come back to why I am doing this. Let's say the time taken to calculate fib of n minus 1, which is tn minus 1, is almost equal to the time taken to calculate fib of n minus 2, which is tn minus 2. Now in reality, the time taken to calculate fib of n minus 1 is greater than the time taken to calculate fib of n minus 2. So what we are trying to do here is we are trying to kind of calculate a lower bound for tn, the time taken to calculate fib of n. So now tn would be 2 times t of n minus 2 plus 4. Let's say we write this 4 as a constant c. So c is equal to 4, is a constant that adds up into this expression. Now let's try to reduce this expression. T of n minus 2 can be written as 2 times t of n minus 4 plus c. So this expression eventually reduces to 4 t n minus 4 plus 3 c. And again, n minus t n minus 4 can be reduced to t n minus 6. So this will be 8 t n minus 6 plus 7 c. And we can go on like 16 t n minus 8 plus 15 c and so on. Now, if I want to reduce it by some generic value, then we can say that this is equal to 2 to the power k times t of n minus 2 k plus 2 to the power k minus 1 into c. And you can verify that this expression is true for all the values of k. Like this is equal, this is true, this is k is equal to 2, this is k is equal to 3, this is k is equal to 4, and this is our tn. Now if I want to write this in terms of t0, which is known to us, then in that case n minus 2k would be equal to 0. That will imply k is equal to n by 2, and our expression tn will be reduced as 2 to the power n by 2 t 0 plus 2 to the power n by 2 minus 1 c. And this is nothing but 1 plus c into 2 to the power n by 2 minus c. So in simple terms, we can say here that tn is proportional to 2 to the power n by 2. and this is a lower bound for us, the lower bound for the time taken. And I'll clear this calculation in the right here. Now let's try another approximation this time. Let's say the time taken to calculate fib of n minus 2, which is tn minus 2, is almost equal to tn minus 1. Now this reduces our expression, or this simplifies our expression, as tn is equal to 2 times t of n minus 1 plus constant c, and c is equal to 4. Now in reality, tn minus 2 will be lesser than tn minus 1, so this expression is kind of giving an upper bound this time, and we can go on reducing this particular expression similar to what we had done before. So this will be 4t n minus 2 plus 3c, which is again equal to 8t n minus 3 plus 7c, and if I have to reduce it in some generic form, then this is equal to 2 to the power k t n minus k plus 2 to the power k minus 1c. Now if I want to write this expression tn in terms of t0, then n minus k will be equal to 0, which will imply k is equal to n, and that would mean that tn is equal to 2 to the power n t0 plus 2 to the power n minus 1 into c, and t0 is nothing but 1, so this will finally be 1 plus c into 2 to the power n minus c. So in simplest of terms, in this particular case, we can say that tn is proportional to 2 to the power n, and this is our upper bound. Upper bound because we have approximated tn minus 2 to be tn minus equal to tn minus 1, while in reality it will be lesser than tn minus 1. We have used approximations because it was a lot easier using these approximations to reduce this expression and show it to you that the time taken by this program grows exponentially with the input. So even if we take the lower bound of 2 to the power n by 2, then for a simple input like n is equal to 100, this program will take years to give you the result. The order of the growth of tn would be somewhere in between the lower bound and the upper bound, but in complexity analysis we often see the closest upper bound to make a sense of the runtime of the program in the worst case. Now I'll clear this calculation in the right here. Big O notation, which is one of the most famous notations to describe time complexity of a program, actually represents the upper bound of the growth of the function, or rather the upper bound of the growth of the time. So we can say in this case that this particular algorithm is having a time complexity which is big O of 2 to the power n. So fib recursion, which is a recursive implementation of Fibonacci sequence, has a complexity big O of 2 to the power n. If we would have written an iterative implementation using loops, then the complexity would have been big O of n, or in other words, this algorithm is order of n. If an algorithm is order of n in terms of time complexity, such an algorithm is called linear time algorithm. And if an algorithm has time complexity of the order of something like a to the power b, then such an algorithm is called exponential time algorithm. Now a linear time algorithm, or an algorithm of order n, is a lot better than exponential time algorithm. In fact, exponential time algorithm is the algorithm with the worst kind of time complexity. For example, in this particular case, using this iterative method, for an input as high as a million, we will get the result within no time, while for recursive implementation, which has an exponential runtime, for an input as small as n is equal to 100, we will not get the result within a reasonable time. We will dig deeper into complexity analysis of programs and all these notations like big O notation in couple of more lessons. So thanks for watching.